one every year. And normally it would be in the South Melbourne Town Hall in Victoria, but obvious reasons it can't do that. But very grateful to be here. This is a beautiful new room that St. George's has just built. So thank you, Christoph, and to Ian for letting us use it. They also have a beautiful restored Bechstein piano, which is from the 18th century? 19th century. Which is actually perfect for this sort of repertoire because piano development since then has kind of been towards power and volume, which is actually not necessarily what you want for a piece like this. In this sort of piece, you kind of want the piano to be part of the ensemble and not to overpower. So it's great. It's a fantastic opportunity. And leaves would be great. And this piece is also, funnily enough, it's called Quartet in G minor, and actually only one movement is in G minor. The second one's in B flat, if I mentioned, and then G major. Some obscure joke, I'm sure. But it's all just drama. Like, the whole thing is just the sort of music that you would hear at the opera. It's very, what you see is what you get, and the gestures are very clear, but it doesn't necessarily mean that the music is also simple. It's quite a lot of work that goes into making sure that there's clarity and that you can actually hear these gestures straight away. So, which actually makes it a lot of fun to play, to be able to just pass these things around and have fun. So, hope you enjoy Mozart's Quartet in G minor.
Thank you.
Piece we're going to play for you is Brahms' Sextet No. 1. Now, it might not be immediately obvious to everyone, but this is a string quartet plus an extra viola and cello, and I say that because it's actually quite important for the way that Brahms has orchestrated or arranged this piece. I'm not a maths person, as many of you know, but I assume there's more permutations of six people than there are of four, and Brahms does actually use many more combinations of people. Like often I'm playing with Sean and Krista, and often Alex, Elliot, and Jeremy are playing together as a trio, and then you could have duos, and it's. And I think the reason that he does this is because he's really trying to pack in as much expressive content as he can. Like this is basically a symphony in miniature, so there's lots of communication between different people, and one of the other impressions that I kind of get from this piece. Because none of us have played this before, and I haven't really heard it before studying it just for this concert. Is that it's very thick, and so sometimes it means that it's hard to move the whole thing in a free way. But actually, I think that is the beauty of playing Brahms, because Brahms more generally is also known for having very thick textures, and it's kind of amazing and beautiful to see this like big, magnificent sort of beast of an ensemble move with like the fluidity of a dancer at points. And this whole first movement is a waltz. I just wanted to give you some sort of insights into how we sort of feel when we're playing it and the things we've been talking about. And I also just wanted to say that often when we listen to romantic music or music from around that time, you can feel a little bit detached from the world that we live in, because it's so full of emotional content like this. It can seem a little bit sickly sweet at times, or too intense. But that was actually a feature of Romanticism, is that they were very interested in exploring like their own humanity through through the peaks and troughs of human experience, like through, you know, they were very interested in composers who were deaf, who were still writing symphonies, or painters who were cutting their ears off. Like, they were interested in, like, the peak experience of human nature. And today, I think we're more interested in, like, how the everyday and mundane reveals parts of our character. And so I think for that reason, it can feel a little bit lofty, but actually this music would have been very immediate to people who heard it at the time, and they would have really resonated with it. So whatever you notice when you're listening to this piece, whatever you pay attention to, just notice how it changes and shifts and how the melodies are passed around the ensemble. And I hope you enjoy this sextet by Brahms.
Thank you.